Be seated. Hello, my name is Karen Ptolemy-Stamm. I'm the minister here at St. Paul's United Church. And I join with you in this congregation in grieving the loss of John Edwin McGrory. And we come here today, not only those of us who are present here in the sanctuary, and the snow has caused some people to take the online option, but we also want to acknowledge all of you who are watching online, both live streaming and then after when it's uploaded. Thank you. Each and every single one of you in person and online for honoring us by being here to grieve with this family, to support one another in love, to know that our God is with us, the God who knows about tears as well as laughter. The God who knows about both life and death and life beyond death. And so we gather this day. Every Sunday, a small child lights this Christ candle. This past week, it was a three-year-old. Was a little excited. We have a child here. Would you like to come up and light the candle with me? Yeah, no, the guy behind you, the little one. Hey, this works. How lovely is this? Because John would have known that children light the Christ candle. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this and we're going to light it from the Christ candle because John was a Christian. And we always say on Sunday mornings, may this light remind us that Jesus is the light of the world and the light in our lives. So can you take this and we're going to light this candle. Come on over and we're going to light this candle. And this candle is in memory of John. And we are thankful for that. Thank you so much. John would have been proud of you. You can have a seat now. Let us pray. In this place we gather, O God. Indeed, be near to us. Help us to trust your presence in your Holy Spirit. Help us to remember that the light of Christ still shines, even in the darkness of grief and loss. Be with us as we celebrate John's life, as we lift up hearts of gratitude for him. Be with us as we mourn together in the midst of tears. And be with us, O God, as together we support one another, as God would have us do. All this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Our opening hymn, for those of you who are in the pew, the words are printed in your bulletin. And the choir is going to lead us today in music. Thank you so much for having you here today, our choir. And Debbie used to sing in the choir with the guys, no less. She's got this lovely low voice. And so the words are in your bulletin.
Stars that we have to
You may be seated. At this point, I'm going to invite Scott to come forward, and he is one of John's sons, and Danielle, his bride, is going to be standing with him. Thank you, Scott.
My dad loved a lot of things, in no particular order: fishing, Dairy Queen, home renos, his snowblower, his truck, his boats and outdoor toys, and most of all, Debbie and our family. Oh, no. Oh, sorry. I'm good. You know what? Fishing should maybe be in there one more time, because he definitely loved to fish and talk about fish and then fish some more. One time on a trip to visit us in Burlington, he looked down from a bridge into a shallow concrete spillway and said, "I bet there's fish in there," and there definitely wasn't. But that was John choosing to see the fishy side of life. John will certainly be missed by all of us today, especially by Debbie, my brothers Michael and Martin, and their families, stepbrother Bradley, and my wife Danielle and I. Despite all the love that we have here for John, he has lots of love waiting for him up in heaven. My mom Margaret, his sister Helen, and puppy pals Little B and Newbie. And we rest easy knowing that he's looking around heaven and thinking, "There's fish in here."
At this point, thanks so much, Scott, aka Scotty. We are now going to have a video show, and it is a walk down memory lane.
Thank you.
this time I invite Danielle to come up for the fisherman's prayer.
The Fisherman's Prayer. God grant that I may live to fish until my dying day, and when it comes to my last cast, then I most humbly pray. When in the Lord's safe landing net I'm peacefully asleep, that in his mercy I be judged as good enough to keep.
Thank you so much. We have two scripture readings today. The first is the 23rd Psalm, well known and much beloved by so many. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And the next is something that Jesus said in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28. Jesus said this, and it's true, especially for us today. Come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We gather today to remember, to laugh as we have to with John McGrory. Some of the pictures were just so much fun. Did they not bring back some wonderful, wonderful memories for some of you? And I just want to say that as a fisherman, John would have been very familiar with bones, right? Constantly pulling them out. So I'm just saying he's got a bone to pick with you guys. If you take a look at this picture that was distributed, and it's been up on the screen, it's the smallest fish. And Debbie says it's probably the biggest fish he ever got. So we're having a laugh at that because, as you could see, John has caught an awful lot of huge fish. But today, this picture was chosen because John, when he got that little minnow, laughed and laughed and laughed. And so even the picture chosen is such a gift to all of us. So I'm glad there might be fish in heaven, because if this is his last one, he won't be happy. In this time, as we gather, for those of you who are in Scotland or Newfoundland or Fort Nelson or watching from other places online, what you don't know is we've had the first major snowstorm of the year. And I know Southern Ontario isn't very well known for snow, except here in this region, and we are in the snow belt. And so the wind has been blowing, the plows have been out, it's slippery, and we are today not only grateful for those of you who made it today in person, we thank you, but for those of you who have also come online. Winter is a hard time, and so is death. And there's an awful lot of grieving and loss, and it's a difficult time. Debbie, no one has to tell you how much John loved you. Yeah. And the two of you together, you had an awful lot of fun, tremendous memories, and John was so blessed to have you in his life. And You know, Debbie have always called John her Vinny. And if you hear her refer to John as Vinny, she would say, oh yeah, he's my Vinny. He's the vinegar and I'm the honey. Exactly. And at times he could be a tad vinegary. No. But he could also be this man who just lived life to its fullest. And we are so grateful that he found you. Scott, your dad, you know, you lost your mom when you were 14 years old. And he had an incredible life with Margaret and with you. And still, when she died at such a young age, he was able to find Debbie and still have you, and you were able to create a family, and that's when Bradley came in. So John was my three sons, and then Bradley came into the picture, and it's my four sons, and we're grateful that love is something that could be shared. And of course, for you, Michael and Martin, and for your families in Scotland, your dad moved away from Scotland a long time ago when you were little, and then you were able to be reconnected. And how marvelous for the family from Scotland to be reconnected, especially now that John has died so young and so soon. And so some of the pictures you saw were actually pictures of them here in Canada, or when you guys went over to Scotland. And so we know you can't be here today, but we're also very aware that you are present online and with us in spirit. And so for the whole gang in Scotland, you are very much in our thoughts and prayers. So you can see I'm looking directly at the camera right now so that I can help them to understand and know that we're very much aware that they are here. And you know, no amount of words in one service can ever capture all of the stories and all of the memories. But the memories continue and they live in us. And we are so grateful for this man, for not only those of you who are family members who are grieving, but for friends and neighbors and fishing buddies, the whole gamut. And of course, those in your faith family as well. Winter's hard, and it reminds us that there are hard times in our lives where there's coldness and there's loss and it seems like everything is dying. But you know, we know that spring is going to come. And we trust that the spring of new beginnings, knowing that you're going to get through this, knowing that there's still love and laughter to be found in the world, knowing that the new day will still bring moments of joy and you won't be lost and buried in this grief that feels like a blanket of snow. For that we are grateful. We believe in God who walks with us through all things, even the toughest moments, especially in the toughest moments. And so this day, as we remember God who walks through the valley of the shadow of death with us, may we all be assured of God's love and God's presence. And as we, for those of us in person who can speak to the family directly, and those of you online who I'm sure will be sending emails and cards and things, may we remember that we do not walk alone. That not only is God with us, but God invites us to share love and support and care and strength for one another. And as we embrace others, they may feel the embrace and love of God too. So spring is around the corner. There is resurrection, not only for John, But resurrection in our day-to-day living. May God be with you in all of that. Amen. Our next song is a song that I know Debbie has really also loved. It's called Here I Am, Lord, I the Lord of Sea and Sky. Seated. Let us pray. Holy One, as we come before you, we know indeed that we are held in the palm of your hand and in your heart, and that you call us to have in our hearts your people. Today especially, we have the McGrory family in our hearts. And we just ask that you will be with them and all who grieve this day. We pray especially for Debbie. We ask that you will be with her as she works to recreate normal in her life. And we pray for John's sons and their partners, for Scott and Danielle, for Michael and Jessica, for Martin and Jillian, and for his stepson Bradley. We pray for his grandchildren, for Katie, for Emma, for Laura, for Callum, and for Jamie. And we pray for his sister Lorraine. Holy God, we pray for friends, many friends, and for neighbors, and as I mentioned, fishing buddies and faith family members, and all who grieve this day and who walk this road of grief. Surround us with your grace. Help us know a deep and abiding sense of inner peace. Help us to trust, as Jesus promised, that he will come and he will indeed give rest to those who are struggling and walks with us. As we celebrate John's life, we give you thanks for him, O God. And we know that tears are a language that you understand. And we ask that you will be with us in the midst of broken hearts as we seek to mend and to know of the promise of resurrection. Holy One, we thank you that we can be together this day, both in person and online. Help us to trust you, O God, as we reach out to support and love one another. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. For those of you who are of the Christian faith and who know this prayer, I invite you to join with me in the Lord's Prayer. If you are of the Catholic tradition, you call it the Our Father. The Protestants call it the Lord's Prayer. Catholics, just a little surprise at the end, because we Protestants, we just add a little extra line. So let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. I'd like to invite all of you who are here in person to follow the family out, and we're going to go down the stairs and into the great hall, and we are actually going to be piped out. And if you require an elevator, we do have a person, Don Penrose, who's in the choir, and he's going to assist you on the elevator should you need one. So as we go in one direction, those going in the elevator will need to head to your left and around the corner into the atrium. At this point, I invite you please to rise. We have grieved together, John McGrory, and we thank God that he was in our life. And as we extinguish this candle, we know that although he has died, he lives. For we believe that God is with us. In life, in death, and life beyond death. Thank you, John, for being part of our lives. as we go forward from this place in our grief and our tears, and even with laughter, who cannot laugh at some of those pictures and the John moments? Know that God walks with us in all things. May you know the deep and abiding presence of God in your life. May you know the grace of Jesus Christ. And may you know that the Holy Spirit is in you and in our world. Thanks be to God. Amen.